Superstitious. Hello, I'm Nicole Hanselman. Today I'm talking about superstitions. If you haven't subscribed, please do and turn on your notifications. Well, we all know superstitions are just fun, cute, harmless, probably. Yeah, and those are the ones we want to talk about. If yours isn't, if it's affecting your life, please do something about it. If it's not serving you, maybe we learn a thing or two on how to make them serve you, right? This is what this is all about, isn't it? You know, guys with repetitive behaviors, you know, that is an issue, that is a problem, that is something that's affecting your life. You got to have it sorted. So, what are some of the superstitions we know of? I'll start with Friday the 13th because I don't get it. I learned of it and I don't get it. I don't know whether there is half moon. Some people don't want to go out anymore. And you're ruining a beautiful day. Don't do that if you can help it. I don't want to believe in Friday the 13th one. Mm-mm. You're not going to ruin a beautiful day. But that 13th thing is a big thing. It's a big thing to a lot of people, a big number. For a long time, I think it's still happening. Most of the houses in England, you'll go from like 11, 12, then they'll rather have 12A than 13. So they'll go 11, 12, 12A, 14, or some they'll just keep it completely, no pretending, not doing 13. It's crazy, but I don't know. Maybe 13 is not a good number. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. I don't want to figure that out. What is that? The other superstitions that we have? Oh, stabbing of the toe when you're walking, you know that one? I don't mind that one because it's just a little bit of a reminder, you know, to just maybe say a little bit of a prayer. You know, did you pray today? Making me aware of myself, aware of my surrounding. Just those reminders to be grateful for our life. So stabbing of the toe is not too bad. Some people, when they stab the toe when they're going somewhere, then I don't know, they have to go back, I don't know, something like that. If it's the right one, then it's something good. If it's the left one, it's something bad, it's bad luck and stuff. Yeah. The other superstition that we know of is the palm one. A lot of us love the palm one. It's a nice, cute one, isn't it? If you have the right palm, you know, like money, you know what I do? I go like, all right, ask somebody, kiss it for me, money's coming in. But I don't believe that the left one is losing money. Why do you want to believe in something that's too negative? For me, I decided anything that's not serving me, bring it out of the window. I don't want it in my life. Mm-mm. So for me, I've decided, you know what, that money, the left one is the one that caters for staff, bills, blah, blah, blah. It's the one that goes helping charities, the community. I'm not really losing it. It's not like money, you know, like somebody's called you, fleeced you, dropped it off your purse, off your bag. No, I don't want to believe in that one. I don't want that one. I just want good ones. Superstition is, oh, fingers crossed one. I want to use fingers crossed right now. Why? I wanted this video today to be just a fun video, and fingers crossed it will be. Lately we've been talking about so many sad things and we are losing, you know, the happy vibe. So let's see, fingers crossed. The other one, touch wood. I learned that in England too. So like if you said something, say for instance, I was talking to somebody, telling you there's a lot of flu going on right now. I hope I don't get it. Touch wood, I don't want to use corona anymore. I was hoping not to talk about corona today. But touch wood, none of my friends will catch it. None of my friends will get corona, so touch wood. A funny thing about touch wood, you can use anything. And some people don't get it. It's supposed to be, you know, the wood. But people use anything that's by you, that's what you touch, and you say touch wood. Funny about that. Actually, when I was growing up, we had something similar. We did have something similar. If he was talking about something, we did something like we pretended to spit. So it's a pretend spit. So you do something like, say, okay, we're talking about the flu again. Like, there's a lot of flu going on. I hope I don't catch you. Or if you say, I feel like I caught it, you go like, to reverse the curse, to break the cycle, to, I don't know, but it kind of works when you do something. But at the end of the day, I think you're just telling your brain, you know what, I don't want this, I don't want that. So the brain listens. Yeah, mind over matter. Our brains are really powerful. Whatever you feed it, it's whatever it takes. Your surrounding is based on that brain. Yeah, your surrounding, everything tells you what is up there. Cool. Another one. Oh, the cat one. Yeah, when a black cat crosses your path, that's bad luck. Some people have to go back home. Oh, I don't want to do that. I don't want to. Poor cats, lovely creatures. Somebody decided, no, you bring bad luck. And I don't know. And the other people, the ambulance, if they are driving somewhere, if they hear it, it's to them, it's not good too. There's a lot of things out there, really. If you want to believe them all, it goes on and on. Another one, the ladder. Yes, going under the ladder. I don't care. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Sometimes I'm aware of it. I'm like, oh, should I go under the ladder or not? The heck, I don't believe in it, so why should I be tied by it? So the one I want to concentrate on, yeah, is mirrors and glasses. Mirrors, yeah, scares the crap a lot of people. Mirrors scares a lot of people. So for some people, mirrors, if you break a mirror, that's 7 years of bad luck, right? Somebody decided to ruin 7 years of their lives believing in that. And the glass one, it's just bad luck. I don't think there's years on it, but it's just bad luck. So for me, I did do that. I did have the, you know, mirrors and glasses thing. Years and years ago, decade, 2006, I had what I want to call a successful business until it wasn't. So when it was doing well, something started happening, some craze, you know. I don't know, there's a staff who broke a mirror, then there was a glass table that broke, and then I don't know, when I went home, I noticed that I was just like kind of breaking glasses, and I thought, ooh, whatever is coming my way must be big. So during this time, when things started going down with the business, we had to move to a new dwelling. I was living with my cousin, we are young girls, starting life, you know, happy and stuff, you know. So we found this place. And it was a cute place, two-bedroom house, nice area, yeah, I'll get it, you know, you're young, you're thinking, yeah, we've made it. So as we stayed there, there was this, our landlord would send his staff to a place every week. On a weekly basis, somebody came. And they'll be like, oh, I don't know, checking the electricals, or I don't know, there's a painting to be done, or there's something faulty in here. They always had an excuse, and they always went, I think it was the toilet, they would go to the toilet every time. And we found it really weird, and we talked about it. So my cousin, being the detective she is, and the brave girl she is, oh, Rispashara, she decided to go. She talked to the neighbors and heard that. A lot of people stayed there for a short time. It was all short leased. There's nobody who lived there for too long. And so she decided to confront the guy. The next time the guy came, she was like, no, you're not coming in. We didn't sign for you. I'm not letting you in. And so she didn't let him in. And a few days later, the landlord appeared, came in person, like, I want you out of my house. And he was like, he was going to give us our deposit back. Everybody was like, he never gives deposit back. It's not gonna happen. You've lost your money. You wait and see. It said that we were the first people that ever got the deposit back from the guy. Yeah. So you know what was happening? You know, during this time when all this time that this landlord was coming, those, you know, a lot of stories about, you know, such people when they have such homes, they do strange things to them. Those a lot of such stories. And then, during that same time, at night, we are in bed, sleeping. My cousin is in the next room. I hear somebody call out my name. I go to her room. I check on her, and I'm like, okay, hi. Because she had a little one by that. And I thought she might want something. So I answered. And she was like, yeah, I did hear somebody call you, but it wasn't me. It came from outside. It came from that end. No way. She was like, yeah, I didn't call you. We knew nobody knew my name around that area. Nobody knew me. People hardly saw me. I used to be a person who comes home and leaves. I was hardly known. Who would call me by my name? I was like, And I answered. People used to say that if you answer to such calls at night, you'll stop existing. You won't be there anymore. So all these things happening to me. But the good thing is we had my mom, you know, and friends and family, you know, there was always people who were ready to support us. We're like, you're going to pray. We're going to pray. So people were really praying for us. And during this time, we put lots of Bibles just before we moved out. Lots of Bibles in every room. Yeah, you can imagine me being paranoid about that. I wonder if I would do the same now. I'm too crazy for that. But we'll put Bibles in every room. We actually even had a Bible in the bathroom. The King James Version, the tiny little one, the blue ones. We had that in the bathroom because we were that, you know, scared. We're thinking, what's happening? Goodness me. But anyway, after that, that's when I like fell sick. I don't want to dwell on the sad stories today. So yeah, I did become sick. The story I've told you before, for those who have been following, and at the time that I became sick and lost my hearing. But other than that, I'm here well and good. I'm fine. I decided to be in anything that doesn't serve me. I decided to change my mindset. I decided to believe in only the good things. So today, if I broke a glass, I tell myself, you know what? Anything bad that was coming my way has been broken. Yeah, I tell myself good things. I tell myself, you know what, my angels are trying to tell me, we are busy working, we are busy looking after you. It's not gonna work. The thing that's coming after you, it's not gonna reach you. We are so busy. You just sleep, my darling, sleep, enjoy your life. So anyway, that's the discussion for today. What is your superstition? What do you believe in? What do you still believe in? What have you changed? Have you changed anything? Did you used to believe in something and decided, no, this is not serving me? No, no more, not doing it anymore. Use that comment section to tell me that. So for today's recommendation is Atomic Habits by James Clear. Yeah, why this book? Because I believe that there's always room for improvement, always room for self-development, and you know what? Why don't you read it? Then tell me. Use the comment section to tell me what you thought about it. Because I've got a long list of books and read books. I'm getting there. You know, every day just like, yeah, I'm getting there. I really would like to know what you think about it. I've read the sample again. And I'm like, oh, this could change someone's life. Tell me about it. For today, we're done. And bye.